If you try to use radius option from dimension to give radius of isometric circle, then it will give error, object selected is not a circle or arc. Therefore, to specify isometric circle radius, you will have to use leader. Click here on leader. Then take your cursor to quadrant, click, then take your cursor away, then click, then you will have to specify radius value manually. So type there R30 and click outside. And if you want internal line, then click here on line, then click here on quadrant and click on center point, press escape. So in this way you can specify radius. And if you want to specify diameter, then you will have to use align dimension. So click here on this arrow and click on aligned. Then click here on quadrant and this quadrant and again click on quadrant. So here this dimension is added. Then to edit this text, double click on it. Then for diameter symbol, click here and click on diameter, then specify diameter of 60, then to remove existing dimension, press delete and click outside and press escape. So here this dia 60 is added, and if you want this dia 60 to be outside, then click on this dimension and take your cursor to this blue grid and click here on move with dimension line, take it outside and click and press escape. So in this way you can give diameter dimension for isometric circle. Then if you want to give diameter from these two points, then for that again you will have to use align dimension. So click here on align. Then in the case of isometric, quadrant is below. So to catch this point, you will have to take your cursor to this end point and take it away. So it will track that point in 210 degree. If in your case it is not tracking in 210 degree, then for that you will have to make some settings. So to make settings, click here on this arrow near polar tracking and ensure that you have selected this 30, 60, 90 and 120. Then click here on tracking settings and select this track using all polar angle settings. Then click on OK. Click here on this intersection point, again take your cursor to this center point or end point and track it, click, take it below and click. Then to apply diameter symbol, just double click on it and click here on symbol, click on diameter, click outside, press escape. Then to make it perfectly vertical, click here on annotate, click here on dimensions and click here on oblique. Then select this object, press enter and specify oblique angle of 90 degree, enter. So here this diameter is also added, and if you want to move it on this side, click on it, click on this grip, take your cursor on this side and click, press escape. So that's all. If you want to learn isometric basics in more detail, then you can watch this video. And if you want to see all the tutorials about isometric from our channel, then here is the playlist. Then please like, share and subscribe by clicking here on this icon. So thanks for watching. We will again meet in next tutorial.